All right, so when you are busy and on the go, as we all are, it's easy to fall victim to quick and easy options. Well, they're not always the healthy ones. But Lindsay Bailey, dietitian with Akron Children's Hospital, is here to show us the light with some better options. So I love these ideas because we were saying it's beautiful. So display kind of is everything, especially when you're trying to get kids to eat their vegetables.
Absolutely.
You're like, look how cute this is. Don't you want to eat it?
Presentation is big.
It is.
So we really do eat with our eyes first.
Yeah.
So we want to make these things appealing to kids. So when we're telling kids, like, eat your fruits and vegetables, how we present them makes a big difference.
Right. And I think it's great for those who maybe are on diets and are trying to eat certain portions.
Sure.
It's good to just, boom, just eat that instead of the whole bag of chips.
These are definitely portion controlled.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so where do we start?
We're going to start on the end here. So we think about food and how do we make this easier. The containers are important.
Okay.
So start with containers. I have two different types here. So these little plastic ones are really easy and portable. Mm-hmm. I got these at a party center.
Okay.
And then mason jars are great too. So anytime I have anybody bring over something in a mason jar, I keep it. I'm like well known.
You're
in my
one of those,
office.
Lindsay.
I'm well known in my office for transporting food in a mason jar. So people see these sitting around all the time. But they're awesome. They're reusable and they're easy to take in your lunch, type snacks in. So the container's important.
Okay.
I'm getting a little innovative here. So don't throw away your cup holders that you get when you're going out to eat or grabbing your morning coffee, because they're great for storing these snacks.
Idea.
So they stack. They're great for taking in the car and also stacking in your refrigerator and having a couple of snacks stacked and ready to go.
Okay, so we need ideas on snacks.
I have some ideas for you. So what makes a good snack? I hear this from parents all the time.
Yeah.
So we want something that's going to be satisfying and nutritious, and that typically has a carbohydrate and a protein. So all of these contain that. Our first option here are veggies and hummus. And look how wonderful this is. We have the hummus in the bottom layer, and all the veggies are stacked right in the cup. So,
and it doesn't get soggy or anything.
Super easy. It's portable. And then for our carbohydrate source, we have some pretzels to go along with it with the dip.
Okay.
Our next option is grapes and cheese cubes. Mm. So the ones that I chose, cotton candy grapes, if you haven't tried them, are
incredible.
My mom
and I love these and they're so hard to find, but Giant Eagle has them right now.
Yes.
So that's where you got yours.
So these are great because they're very sweet and they actually do taste like cotton candy.
Yeah,
so it's kind of like you're having a dessert, but not. And then these little cheese cubes are Gouda, but you can choose what you'd like.
Okay.
And then I'm pairing it with a 8-seed whole grain cracker. So then we're getting our carbohydrates and our proteins and our fat.
Okay.
And then we have Mexican dip. So refried beans, guacamole, tomatoes, corn,
and
then chips. So for a gluten-free option, since these ones aren't, a blue corn chip.
Okay, so your other idea was to make a salad and
apples and dip.
Ooh.
So apples and peanut butter are a classic combination, and I'm putting a little fall twist on it by making it a maple cinnamon dip.
Yum.
So it's a three-ingredient dip. The natural peanut butter works really well because it's already kind of liquidy.
Yes.
And then we have some maple syrup, so it gives it some of that like fall taste, and then cinnamon. So I love cinnamon. It gives that great fall flavor. You just mix it up.
I want to try that.
I just use a fork. These apples are were pre-sliced, and to keep them nice and bright, just dip them in lemon juice and water. If you don't have one of these, it makes life really handy because it cores your apple for you.
That's delicious. That's a great idea.
So we have a finished product over here. The peanut butter dips in the bottom, and you just stack your apples in there, stick the top on, and you're ready to go.
Cool. Okay, let's make a salad.
Let's make a salad. So I love this salad. It's a transition from summer into fall. We have some summery ingredients.
We love salads.
Fall.
Yes.
So I'm making my own dressing.
Oh.
Now, this might seem a little bit intimidating to some, but there's only three ingredients in it. So we're starting off with an olive oil, so that's a heart-healthy option. I'm actually choosing to use a lemon juice as our acid versus a vinegar.
Okay.
So we just throw that in here.
Okay.
And then I have a little bit of honey for sweetness. So a fork or a whisk works really well. You can actually do it in the jar if you want, but you mix these together, and then you stick it right in the mason jar here.
Okay, now we have to wrap this up, but what do you put in your salad? I love different salads, so I enjoy others.
So I have some arugula, which is a nice dark green leafy vegetable for the fall. This is the only thing that requires cooking, and this is a roasted butternut squash. Some dried cherries, some sunflower seeds for a crunch, and then we have some feta for a little bit of saltiness and a little bit of protein.
Yum, great ideas.
Great ideas, no
doubt.
Yeah,
great.
I like the
pretzels. You know, and you buy these at the store, right? Have you seen the containers that have the hummus and the pretzels layered?
Yeah.
You could make your
own. Do your own. Cheaper.
Cheaper, easier, it stretches.
Exactly.
So it's great for the whole family.
Thank you, Lindsay.
Appreciate
it.